My ex-husband, John George Liss, ended up becoming the second highest ranking colonel in ISIS. I met my husband online, and then we quickly married. We traveled to different continents and mixed with other Islamists. And the goal was to establish an Islamic State caliphate. During this process, while in America, I learned about American values. I learned about freedom of thought, freedom of expression. All these freedoms are devoid in Islam. And I had the fear of missing out. I wanted so much more for my children to give to this world rather than to destroy it. And that's what changed me. The hardest part about being a Muslim woman was suppressing my conscience. Being told that I can't question my religion. I felt uncomfortable with so many aspects of Islam when it came to child marriages, slavery. Before I had children, I was a bit of a dreamer, thinking I would have 7 sons that would conquer 7 continents. After having children, I realized, no way. I did not want to see them on the front lines. I did not want to bury them. And this changed my mindset. Motherhood and my instinct to protect my children became my priority over my religion. And that was it. While I was in Syria at the time, I had, my sons were 8, 4, and 1.5, and I was 5 months pregnant. The conditions of Syria were horrendous. My children and I were all sick, we were malnourished, but ironically, my husband, John, at the time, was willing to help us get out because he knew I wasn't there and I was pretty much suicidal, and he knew I would be killed for my apostasy if I had stayed. Yeah, I reported him to the FBI in front of him. He gave me the phone, the cell phone, to contact the Americans and say, my husband has brought me across the border and I need to get out because if I stay here, you won't have just one American terrorist, but my husband will make my 4 sons into terrorists too. They said, just cross the border. We can't come into Syria to rescue you. You need to cross the border and fly to America. And I was more than happy to give them all the information I could about the situation that I'd seen in Syria and who the people my husband knew. Now my children, I have 4 sons, and they have converted to Christianity, and they're very devout Christians. They go to church every Sunday and they love their community. The collateral damage that my husband has done and the trauma he's caused my family is something we will have to live with for the rest of our lives. But, you know, we're looking forward to our future that we wouldn't have had if we had stayed in Syria. We love America. We have devoted our love and our loyalty to this country since the American government saved our lives. And, you know, I'm only hopeful that it's gonna get better. So I'd like to ask radicals who are returning to the West to question their faith. I would ask them, by following an angry God, is it giving you peace of mind? And I know the answer for them is no, but I need to get them to come to that conclusion through my questions.